Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a topic for you that is the most commonly seen scalp disorder which affects one and all. So that is dandruff. So let me give you an insight of this dandruff, its issues and how to manage this situation in a detailed manner. This is the most exploited or commercially exploited skin or scalp disorder which affects most of the people of any age group. So let me give you a detail about this. So coming to what is dandruff. So before you know what is dandruff, you should know the basics of how our hair structure looks like. So let me give you an insight on that. So let me just check this image here. You can see this is how our hair follicle looks like. So this is the hair follicle, this is the hair root, and this is the hair shaft, which is exposed outside. So along with the hair, there is sebaceous glands which are there surrounding the hair, which will secrete something called as sebum. Okay, so this is basically secreted and released into the epidermal area so that it retains moisture and helps you in maintenance of your scalp. But what happens in dandruff situation is this sebum is overproduced. So if there is overproduction of sebum by sebaceous glands, this can lead to issues. Apart from that, when the sebum is released, it acts as a food. Okay, so overproduction means there is more food. So sebum acts like food, and now organisms are attracted to this situation. So they come and attack this area. So the most important organism which attacks here is yeast-like fungus known as Melanesia. So this is a commonly seen organism in the scalp area, which leads to dandruff issues. So what exactly is the mechanism? You can see in this image here. So this is a healthy scalp. So this is how your healthy scalp looks like. But when you have dandruff issues, so why actually this dandruff issues comes? So that is because of the overproduction of sebum, as I told you. So once there is overproduction of sebum, that sebum is there even in your hair. You can see here this yellow color thing is sebum. And now organisms are attracted to it. They come and attack this and they start feeding on it. They start growing on your scalp. So this will lead to your shedding off of the scalp. So this is a common thing. Your scalp cells will keep shedding off. So this, along with the sebum and organisms together, start clumping together and they flake off. So this is the white flake which comes off as dandruff, which is a combination of sebum, dry cells and organisms. So you might have noticed this. If you have such dandruff issues, you will see that white flakes which are coming out from your hair samples. So in this way, you can see that flaking off of dandruff. So once you are affected by this dandruff issues, definitely you will be scared to wear certain dark colored clothes because you know that the dandruff can fall off and it can be visible. So even though most of the cases this can be harmless, but it can be an embarrassing situation to many of us, and it can flake off from the scalp, as I told you, and it is a commercially exploited skin and scalp disorder. So almost half of the population is suffering from this scalp disorder, and it will affect any age group and any gender from any ethnicity. So it can affect anyone. So we have to take care about our scalp condition so that we do not give a chance to these organisms so that we can stop this issue. So when the dandruff issues becomes more, you may have the itching sensation in your scalp, and even it can lead to redness of the scalp. So these are certain side effects which can be seen along with the dandruff situation. And these keratinocytes are the normal cell lines which are there in the skin. And even in the hair samples, there also there can be issues. So coming to a few causes of dandruff, the most important cause of this is your oily skin. So people who are having too much oily skin because of more production of sebum, that can lead to issues. And if you're not shampooing your scalp properly, that can be a reason. And as I told you, overproduction of sebum can be a reason because this organism wants food and the food is readily available as sebum in your scalp. So they come and attack you. And other issues can be even certain times if you have too much dry skin condition also, it can lead to dandruff because it can start flaking off. Your dry skins can get flaking off and sebum will be always there in your hair sample. So even that small sebum might be sufficient when you have dry skin for the organisms to attack. And even a lot of climatic changes can lead to issues. Like when you have very cold climate, we have a tendency of taking bath with hot water. So that can again lead to the scalp dryness, which might lead to issues. And other sensitivity to hair products. So this can happen when you're very sensitive, your skin is very sensitive, you change your shampoos, that can be a reason for dandruff. And it can be a side effect of shampoo also. So coming to symptoms of this dandruff, so it is most commonly seen in the scalp, as I told you, but dandruff can affect you in other areas also, like your hair. A scalp and hair is common. It can be also seen in your eyebrows. It can be also there in your males, basically in the mustache, shoulders, various other places also. You can see wherever there is hair in your body, any area, there also the dandruff can be formed. So other signs and symptoms which triggers or makes this even more severe is your stress. So when you are even more stressed, that can lead to even more dandruff. So trying to de-stress yourself is a better option. And as I told you, the cold climate is a reason. So when do, should you see a dermatologist? So dermatologists are the specialists who can take care of this. So when you try to take certain home remedies, still the dandruff issue is not going. You even try the anti-dandruff shampoos, still it is not working. Then you better consult a dermatologist. Okay, so they can suggest you better medicated shampoos. So simple anti-dandruff shampoos may not be capable enough in that case. You may have to use certain medicated shampoos, and they are the best person to tell you which medicated shampoo should you go for based on your requirement. Along with that, they may suggest some supplements also, like antifungal agents, which will help in reducing this fungal growth in your scalp area. So now let us see how do doctors actually diagnose this dandruff cause. So basically they do the scalp examination. So this is basically done by the dermatologist. They do the scalp examination and they take little scrapings of the scalp from you, and they culture it in the suitable medium to see which is the actual organism which is causing this issue. And once they know the actual organism, they can suggest suitable treatment steps for that, based on which antifungal agent is more precise for that particular organism. Doing those studies, they can suggest that to you. Or rarely, sometimes they even do scalp biopsy, but this is a very rare thing that they do. But scalp examination is the most commonly one used methodology. So here in the scalp biopsy, they scrape off the scalp cells and they check it under the microscope to see the growth of the organism, and exactly to see which organism is infecting you. So once you understood about what is dandruff and what is basically causing dandruff, next thing that we have to know is how to wash off this dandruff or how to get rid from this dandruff. So there are a lot of shampoos available in the market with a brand name like anti-dandruff shampoos. A lot of companies are coming up with this. But these, most of them are synthetic shampoos, and they will have various active ingredients in them like salicylic acid, ketoconazole. So this ketoconazole is an antifungal agent. And salicylic acid will help in maintaining the scalp health, and various other products are also there, or active ingredients are also there in these kind of anti-dandruff shampoos. But most of the synthetic shampoos will use harsh chemicals like sodium lauryl sulfate, which is having toxic effect on your hair. So there is a need, and even when these reach the ecosystem, they will have a negative impact on the treatment plants, and it will have a negative impact on us again. So there's a need for herbal products and herbal shampoos to get rid of these kind of issues. So because of the toxicity that can be generated by these kind of synthetic shampoos, now people are getting more aware about this, and they're trying to shift or trying to change from this kind of synthetic shampoos to herbal shampoos. So let me give you an option for hair shampoo, the herbal anti-dandruff shampoo also. So this is from Atrimed, called as the Skaroff. So this is basically designed for people who are having dandruff. So this is an anti-dandruff remedy which is completely herbal. Okay, so this will prevent further instances of dandruff also. So that is a good choice, and it will maintain the healthy scalp, so which is very important. So this will cost you approximately 180 rupees for 100 ml. And apart from that, you have Kadi Natural Neem and Patanjali Keshkanti, which also have their anti-dandruff shampoos. So coming to some home remedies, coriander seeds are very good for removing this kind of materials that is your yeast growing in your scalp. So you can try to prepare an oil from these kind of coriander seeds, and that can be applied to the scalp. You can even use neem oil, which has got antifungal activity. Coconut oil can be used. You can have even curds to rub your scalp nicely, and that can be used as a home remedy. Again, you can use certain masks like a combination of this. And you can have even tree tree oil, you can have lemon, and you can even have apple cider vinegar. So most of these citrus fruits and apple cider vinegar will help in maintaining the acidic pH, which will be not beneficial for the growth of these fungus. So in that way, you can try to avoid these organisms infecting you. And once they stop infecting you, definitely the issue of dandruff can be stopped. So coming to few takeaway messages. Please try to keep your scalp clean and wash your hair regularly. Get the right shampoo. So based on your needs, you have to choose which is the right shampoo for you. And see to it that you do not use very hot water to take bath when it is very cold here. Okay, so you can try to avoid very hot water because that can lead to dryness of your scalp, which can lead to issues. And try to brush your hair regularly because once you brush your hair regularly, it improves the blood circulation in the scalp. And that will eliminate the flakes to some extent. So if there are no flakes available in the scalp, the chances of growth of this organism can be reduced. And as much as possible, try to avoid processed, packed and refined food because that can in turn increase the production of sebum, which can lead to dandruff issues. So try home remedies as much as possible. If that is not possible, go for anti-dandruff herbal shampoos. And if that also doesn't work, then finally go to a dermatologist and get medicated shampoos to treat yourself. So one more important tip that I want to tell you is please do not oil your hair and leave it overnight. So we have a tendency of oiling our hair in the night and next day morning you take a head bath. But that is the most important and most big problem that we are doing to ourselves. Because when you apply your hair with oil and leave it overnight, what happens is the chance of these organisms growing and feeding on this oil becomes more. So you're giving more time for it to feed. So once they start feeding and they start growing, the chance of dandruff formation increases even more. So this is the most important thing. So if you are having these issues of dandruff, please do not oil your hair overnight and leave it. You can oil it 1 hour before the bath and have a nice massage to your hair and finally take bath. So in that way, you can try to avoid dandruff. So these are the references, and thanks for watching and supporting me till now. Please share it with maximum people and do subscribe our channel for more updates. Thank you.